I've worked on the show every single day, including bank holidays and Christmases, for 10 years. I'm proud of having got to the end and having done what I said I would do. My own mother was, to the month, the same age as the Queen. And so part of what I was originally doing was writing to understand my mother's generation. You know, my mother was also, obviously, you know, from the war generation. She had that sort of uncomplaining, stoical frugality, and I could really connect with that. The Queen was both a very ordinary person and a completely unique and remarkable person.
Congratulations, Prime Minister.
If the show is a train, the train has moved at a speed of a decade a season. So over the six seasons, we've explored around 60 years. And it was always my feeling that I didn't want to come right up to the present. I always wanted to remain a careful distance away from where we are now. How do you make an ending? Because I think we all thought six seasons is perfect, two seasons for each queen. How do you do it when actually nothing happened? You know, people have said to me, when are you ending it? And I say, in 2005, they go, what happened? And you say, well, Charles married Camilla. So we had to construct narratively an episode in which you were genuinely satisfied that you had reached the end, even though you were almost 20 years from the end. So I wrote the final episode being an internal conversation that the Queen was having about whether she should carry on or whether she should hand over to Charles. I thought one could dramatize the eternal dialogue with her in conversation with her younger self.
I don't know what you think you're doing. The crown is a symbol of permanence, of stability, of continuity. If you step down, you will be symbolizing instability and impermanence.
That was a fun challenge because I was completely committed to not coming up to the present day.
You've been on the throne for over half a century. You're almost 80 years old.
No need to go on.
That's what I'm saying. No need to go on.
How does it feel that it's nearly over? Having written 60 episodes of television, I don't think I'm any closer to knowing what I think about the subject. Obviously satisfied at a sense of accomplishment, sad that, you know, the certainty of it will be gone. Relief, because I think it is time to stop, and I think we're stopping just at the right time. And gratitude, because it's changed all our lives, those of us that have worked on it. It's also very satisfying to look at it as a whole and realizing how far we've all come. I loved it. I gave everything to it. I don't think I left anything on the table.